Hi, my name's Sue Larkey. My passion is to help you make a difference to the kids you know who think and engage differently. One of the strategies that I think is so important is to use visuals. Most of the kids I work with are visual learners, but so often people think that's about printing out visuals and laminating them. Visuals are far more than just a visual picture. I would encourage you to think about the environment as a visual, having out that jigsaw puzzle for them so they know what they're going to do. Having a hat, giving them a hat to show they're going outside. Using, giving them a block to indicate to go to the blocks. In the younger years, we can actually use what's called a remnant, part of an activity to help them remember where they're going. Because by giving them that block in their hand, when 30 kids get up and move at the same time, then they've got something to remind them where they're going. We can also use a range of things like the environment, but this can include having out the water play, or this can include having their lunchbox out on the table. So the environment is fantastic. Parts of an activity, visuals are also gesture. Many of my children respond really well to signing. So you might try introducing the sign for finish. Different people use different signs, but as long as you're consistent with your signs, that's what makes the difference. But for me, it's also about pairing the visual with the word, because we're aiming for the child to learn to communicate, or if they don't learn to communicate, to respond to words. So for example, I would be saying finish. Or if I want the child to get a drink, I might be doing this. But some people say, oh, do you want a juice? Do you want a drink? Do you want a water? But if we all use the same sign, it doesn't matter if we're saying drink, water, juice. Actually, that sign is helping the child understand. Remember, body language is part of communication. And so are signs, because so often children with autism spectrum don't develop that same rich gesture that children who are hearing impaired develop. Best of luck, try it out today. Think about where you can use a range of visuals to make a difference to the kids you know.